गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट. ओके, तो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द जनरल गाइडलाइंस, जनरल प्रिंसिपल, फ्यू डेफिनेशंस ऑफ मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट सेपरेटली इन अवर क्लासेस, बट हेयर अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द डिटेल प्रोविजंस ऑफ मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट. फर्स्टली वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद इंट्रोडक्शन. इन इंडिया रिगार्डिंग मोटर व्हीकल, द फर्स्ट स्टैट्यूट इट वॉज द इंडियन मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट 1914. Okay, in 1914, the first Motor Vehicle Act was enacted in India. Remember, at that time, Britishers were there. So, we are having impact of the British Motor Vehicle Act. Okay, so in India, if we are talking about the laws, it is basically originated from the common law system. Because Britishers were there. If we are talking about the law of contract, we are talking about the Property Act, we are talking about CPC. So all the provisions which we are following, somehow they were enacted in British era. The same with the Motor Vehicle Act 1914. It was later on amended by the Motor Vehicle Act 1939. And in spite of several amendments made in the Act of 1939, due to improvement in road network of the country, the necessity for passenger and hire management. Okay, change in the transport techniques of the motor vehicle management, necessity was felt to consolidating and amend the law relating to motor vehicles by suitable legislation. Okay, so on 14th October 1988, assent was given by the President to the Bill of the Motor Vehicle Act and duly passed by both the houses of the Parliament. This act is known as Motor Vehicle Act 1988. Previously there were so many acts passed by the Britishers. Okay, but now the act which we are following right now, it was enacted in 1988, and recently certain amendments were there in 2019. There is a provision regarding the fine. High fine were imposed for committing any offense under this act. Okay, and now what are the objects and scope? Okay, so to take care of the fast increasing number of both commercial vehicles and personal vehicles in India, in the country. Okay, to take care of the fast increasing number of both commercial vehicles and personal vehicles in country. Okay, so why to take care? Okay, if we are talking about the commercial or we are talking about the personal vehicles, so to take care of both kinds of vehicles. Okay, now the need for encouraging adoption of higher technology. Okay, so the need for encouraging adoption of higher technology in automotive sector, the greater flow of passenger and freight with the least impediments, so that island of isolation are not created, leading to regional or local imbalance. Okay, we know for the example ki there are few vehicles, public vehicles, if we are talking about the Mumbai metro or local trains. Okay, so there is a greater flow of passengers. So how to maintain them? Okay, so such kind of provisions for the public vehicles also enacted in the act. It is concerned for the road safety standard and pollution control measures standard for the transportation of hazardous and explosive materials, simplification of procedure and policy, liberalization for private sector operation in the road transport field, need for effective way of tracking down traffic offender, rationalization of certain definitions with additions of certain new definitions of new type of vehicles, laying down of the standard for component and part of motor vehicle, standard for anti-pollution control device, provisions for issuing fitness certificate of vehicles also by the authorized testing station, constitution of road safety councils, the introduction of newer type of vehicles and fast increasing number of both commercial and personal vehicles in the country, providing adequate compensation to victim of the road accident without going into long drawn procedure, protecting consumer interest in transport sector, putting restriction on the alteration of vehicles. Okay, so now we are going to start with that. So these are the general objects, general scope of the area. Okay, the pollution control board related provisions that we are making, they are also the part of the motor vehicle indirectly. Okay, so how to set standard for that? If we are talking about the road accidents, so we are going to cover such matters in MACT, in Motor Vehicle Act only. Okay, so remember these things. So there are so many things which are covered under Motor Vehicle Act. Now, important definitions. Certificate of registration. It means the certificate issued by the competent authority to the effect that a motor vehicle has been duly registered. Motor vehicle has been duly registered in accordance with the provisions of Chapter 4 of Motor Vehicle Act 1988. Conductor, in relation to a stage carriage, means a person engaged in collecting fare. Jo collect karta hai fare, jo kiraya collect karta hai, that person is conductor. From passenger, regulating their entrance into or exit from the stage carriage and performing such other functions as may be prescribed. Driver. Driver include in relation to a motor vehicle which is drawn by another motor vehicle. The person who acts as a steersman of the drawn vehicle. जो चलाता है, जो drive करता है, ठीक है ना? Steering जिसके पास है. Educational institution bus. It means an omnibus which is owned by a college, a school or other educational institute and educational institution and used solely for the purpose of transporting students or staff of the educational institution in connection with any of its activity. Okay, so goods include livestock. Goods means, so we are having the, for goods we are having the other definitions, other definition given in sale of goods act, so we can use that definition only. Transfer of property act, okay, so we can include any of the definitions. So goods includes livestock, anything other than the equipment ordinary used with a vehicle, carried by a vehicle except living persons, but does not include a luggage of personal effect carried in a motor car or in a trailer attached to a motor car to the personal luggage or passenger traveling in the vehicle. So we are not including the personal luggage, okay, in the goods. Goods carriage means any motor vehicle constructed or adapted for the use solely for the carriage of goods. Or any motor vehicle not so constructed or adapted when used for the carriage of goods. Learner's license. The learner's license issued by a competent authority under Chapter 2 of the Motor Vehicle Act 1988, authorizing the person specified therein to drive as a learner a motor vehicle or a motor vehicle of an specified class or description. So learner's license. You are not perfectly, you are not knowing the perfect driving, but now you are learning that. Okay, so it is not the full-fledged driving license. Okay, so there is chapter 2 which is talking about the what is learner's license. Motor vehicle or vehicle means any mechanical propelled vehicle adapted for the use upon roads, whether the power of propulsion is transmitted thereto from the external or internal source and includes a chassis to which a body has not been attached and a trailer, but does not include a vehicle running upon fixed rail or a vehicle of a special type adapted for use only in a factory or in any other enclosed premises, or a vehicle having less than 4 wheels fitted with engine capacity of not exceeding 25 cubic centimeters. Okay, so these are the we can say technical definitions. Owner for the purpose of Motor Vehicle Act. Okay, owner in the Rain Control Act is having a different meaning. Ownership in jurisprudence is having a different meaning. Who can be owner, who can own something. Okay, so here we are talking about owner means a person in whose name a motor vehicle stands registered and where such person is a minor, the guardian of such minor, and in relation to a motor vehicle which is subject of a hire purchase agreement of or an agreement of lease or an agreement of hypothecation, the person in possession of vehicle under the agreement. Private service vehicle. Now, the private service vehicle means a motor vehicle constructed or adopted to carry more than 6 persons. What is private service? More than 6 persons, excluding the driver, and ordinary used by or on behalf of owner of such vehicle for the purpose of carrying person for or in connection with his trade or business otherwise than for hire or reward, but does not include a motor vehicle used for public purpose. Okay.
Now, the second important concept, these are the certain definitions, so you have to go through these definitions, and if you can remember, so kindly try to understand the key terms of these definitions, okay? So if you can remember all the definition, very good. If you can't remember, then kindly go through the definition and kindly try to understand the meaning, okay? Then an accident arising out of use of motor vehicle. An accident arising out of use of motor vehicle. So accident may be with or without motor vehicle, okay? So the expression an accident arising out of the use of motor vehicle is the foundation of a claim. What is this? It is a foundation of a claim in Motor Vehicle Act, in MSCT. ओके मोटर एक्सीडेंटल क्लेम ट्रिब्यूनल के जो मामले आते हैं उसकी हम बात कर रहे हैं. द एक्सप्रेशन एन एक्सीडेंट अराइजिंग आउट ऑफ द यूज ऑफ मोटर व्हीकल इज द फाउंडेशन ऑफ अ क्लेम फॉर कंपनसेशन. तो वी कैन आस्क फॉर कंपनसेशन इन सच मैटर्स एंड इज देयरफॉर अ वाइटल सिग्निफिकेंस विच ऑफ कोर्स नीड एन इंडिपेंडेंट चैप्टर फॉर द कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड मीनिंग देयर ऑफ. ओके नाउ we are just going to discuss these topic, this topic only, okay? An accident arising out of the use of a motor vehicle. In Union of India versus Satish Kumar Patel, the Gujarat State Road Transport Corporation versus, and the second case, Gujarat State Road Transport Corporation versus Union of India, India's matter, where accident do often occur because of the collision between a train and a motor vehicle, usually on unnamed label crossing. And such accidents may take one of the following mode, namely, where there is a negligence only on the part of the driver of the train, where the railway or the driver of a train and the driver of the motor vehicle are both jointly responsible for the accident in question, where the driver or motor vehicle is alone responsible for the accident in question. Okay, so इसमें क्या किया गया बेटा, जब हम बात करें ना एक्सीडेंट की कैसे हो सकती है, जहां पे सिर्फ जो बंदा ड्राइव कर रहा है, मेन जो ड्राइवर है उसकी गलती है, दो अगर गाड़ियां हैं दोनों की गलती है, केवल दूसरे वाले की गलती है. तो अगर हम एक्सीडेंट की बात करें तो तीनों ही तरीके के एक्सीडेंट को हमने यहाँ समझने की कोशिश की है. ओके तो ये जस्ट एक एग्जांपल था. अब है सेलिएंट फीचर्स ऑफ मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट 1988 रिलेटिंग टू द अवॉर्डिंग कंपनसेशन इन मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट केसेस. ओके तो व्हाट वी आर डिस्कसिंग इन मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट, व्हाट आर द सब्जेक्ट मैटर, तो दीज आर द स्कोप, दीज आर द एरियाज व्हाट वी आर कवरिंग इन. तो बेसिकली विच काइंड ऑफ क्लेम, विच काइंड ऑफ कंपनसेशन आर डिस्कस्ड इन मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट 1988, इसमें डिस्कस क्या किया गया, व्हाट इज द थिंग. ओके तो चैप्टर 10 डील्स विद द नो फॉल्ट लाइबिलिटी इन सर्टेन केसेस. No fault liability. तो फर्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग विच इज डिस्कस्ड इन इट, नो फॉल्ट लाइबिलिटी, यू आर नॉट एट फॉल्ट बट यू आर लाइबल. ओके Chapter 11 in the Act deals with the insurance of motor vehicle against third party risk. Okay. Second is talking about the insurance of motor vehicle. Okay. Insurance of motor vehicle in the third party risk. Okay. What is third party? We have also discussed, but again we will discuss in this class. And Chapter 12 of the Act deals with the establishment of claims tribunal. Okay. Application for the award or compensation in cases of accident arising out of use of motor vehicles, recovery of amount of compensation from insurer as arrears of the land revenue and other procedure and incidental matters. Okay. So basically we are discussing these three things. Ab hai no fault liability. What is no fault liability? We have discussed ki where one person is not liable for the accident, that but he is liable to pay compensation. ओके जहां पे गलती नहीं है लेकिन यू आर लायबल एट ऑल. ओके तो सेक्शन 140 टू 144 ऑफ द एक्ट प्रोवाइड्स फॉर द पेमेंट ऑफ कंपनसेशन ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ नो फॉल्ट लायबिलिटी विदाउट एनी फॉल्ट ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ एनी पार्टी. दोनों पार्टीज की गलती नहीं है लेकिन एक्सीडेंट हुआ है और यहां पर आपकी लायबिलिटी पैदा होती है कि आपको पे करना होगा कंपनसेशन. So Section 140 of the Motor Vehicle Act 1988 provides for liability to pay compensation in certain cases on the principle of no fault, where death or permanent disablement of any person has resulted from an accident arising out of the use of motor vehicle or motor vehicles. The owner of the vehicle shall, or as the case may be, the owner of the vehicle shall jointly or severally be liable to pay, both are liable or any one of them is liable. Be liable to pay compensation in respect of the such debt and disablement in accordance with the provisions of this section. Okay, so no fault liability mein there is no fault from the any of the on behalf of any of the parties. Okay, they are not at fault, but again they are liable for the payment. Okay, now the first part, the amount of compensation which shall be payable under section 140 in respect of the death of any person shall be fixed sum. Okay, it shall be always a fixed sum. and the amount of compensation payable under that subsection in respect of the permanent disablement of any person shall be fixed sum of 25,000 rupees. Okay, एक में 50,000 है डेथ हो जाने पर और इसमें 25,000 ये फिक्स्ड है. इन एनी क्लेम फॉर कंपनसेशन अंडर सेक्शन 140 द क्लेमेंट शैल नॉट बी रिक्वायर्ड टू प्लीड एन एस्टेब्लिशमेंट द डेथ ऑफ परमानेंट डिसेबलमेंट इन रेस्पेक्ट ऑफ विच द क्लेम हैज बीन मेड वाज ड्यू टू एनी रॉन्गफुल एक्ट नेग्लेक्ट और डिफॉल्ट. यू आर नॉट सपोज टू प्रूव दीज थिंग इन कोर्ट. ओके, हियर यू आर नॉट एट फॉल्ट और इवन यू आर एट फॉल्ट. ठीक है, नो फॉल्ट लायबिलिटी, इट इज अ फिक्स अमाउंट यू हैव टू पे. ठीक है, अगर एक्सीडेंट हुआ है, मोटर व्हीकल इन्वॉल्वमेंट था, तो ये एक फिक्स पे है, आपको देना ही होगा. इसमें आप ये प्रूव नहीं करोगे, आप ये एस्टेब्लिश नहीं करोगे कि अदर पार्टी का रॉन्गफुल एक्ट था, नेग्लेक्ट था, डिफॉल्ट था. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू प्रूव ऑल दोज थिंग्स. ओके, और डिफॉल्ट ऑफ द ओनर एंड ओनर्स ऑफ द व्हीकल और व्हीकल्स कंसर्न और एनी ऑफ अदर पर्सन. अ क्लेम फॉर कंपनसेशन अंडर सेक्शन 140 शैल नॉट बी डिफीटेड बाय द रीजन of a wrongful act, neglect or default of the person in respect of whose death or permanent disablement claim has been made, nor shall be quantum of compensation recoverable in respect of such death or permanent disablement be reduced on the basis of the share of such person in the responsibility for such death or permanent disablement. Notwithstanding anything contained in section 142 regarding death or bodily injury to any person for which the owner of the vehicle is liable, give compensation for relief, he is also liable to pay compensation under any other law for the time being in force, provided that amount of such compensation to be given under any other law shall be reduced from the amount of compensation payable under this section or under section 163A. Ab isme kya ho gaya? अगर आप यहाँ पे नो फॉल्ट लाइबिलिटी में अगर आप कोई कंपनसेशन लेते हो, तो इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि आप किसी और प्रोविजन में, किसी और लॉ में आप कंपनसेशन नहीं मांग सकते हो. ठीक है, चलिए यहाँ पे किसी व्यक्ति को डिसेबलमेंट के लिए 25,000 कंपनसेशन दिया, किसी और लॉ के किसी और सेक्शन में उस व्यक्ति को 1.5 लाख का कंपनसेशन मिला, तो क्या होगा, 1.5 लाख में से इस 25 को एडजस्ट कर दिया जाएगा. दिस इज अ थिंग. नाउ ही इज एंटाइटल्ड टू गेट 125 इन दैट अदर लॉ. ठीक है, क्या कहा जाएगा कि यहाँ पर ऑलरेडी वो 25,000 ऑलरेडी यहाँ पे ले चुका है या 50,000 यहाँ पे ले चुका है, तो ऐसा नहीं है कि ये आपको किसी और सेक्शन में, किसी और लॉ में क्लेम करने से रोकता है. कंपनसेशन अवॉर्डेड अंडर दिस सेक्शन डज नॉट बार द विक्टिम टू क्लेम कंपनसेशन अंडर एनी अदर लॉ बींग इन फोर्स, दो द अमाउंट ऑफ सच कंपनसेशन टू बी गिवन under any other law shall be reduced by the amount of compensation payable under no fault liability. Under this section, in accordance with the structured formula laid down under Schedule 2 of the Act, with Section 163A of the Act. Okay? तो पहला क्या था, no fault liability. It is the most important part of the Motor Vehicle Act. And second is necessity of insurance against third party risk. Chapter 11 of the Motor Vehicle Act 1988 deals with the Motor Vehicle Act against the third party risk. Section 145 of the Act defines certain terms. ठीक है, authorized insurer, certificate of insurance, liability, policy, property, etc. Which terms are relevant to motor insurance against third party, some of the definitions are as under. So, सबसे पहले हमें इसमें कुछ परिभाषाएं हैं जो समझनी होगी. authorized insurer कौन है? The term authorized insurer means insurer for the time being carrying on general insurance business of India under the General Insurance Business Nationalization Act 1972. तो हर कोई व्यक्ति authorized insurer नहीं बन सकता. उसके लिए क्या होना चाहिए? वह that authorized under which provision authorized under अ पर्टिकुलर एक्ट. कौन सा एक्ट है ये? कि जनरल इंश्योरेंस बिजनेस नेशनलाइजेशन एक्ट 1972 में वो होना चाहिए. एंड एनी गवर्नमेंट इंश्योरेंस फंड ऑथराइज टू डू जनरल इंश्योरेंस बिजनेस अंडर द दैट एक्ट. ओके, नाउ द सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ इंश्योरेंस. द एक्सप्रेशन सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ इंश्योरेंस मीन्स अ सर्टिफिकेट इश्यूड बाय एन ऑथराइज इंश्योरर इन पर्सुएंस ऑफ सबसेक्शन 3 ऑफ द सेक्शन 147 एंड इंक्लूड्स अ कवर नोट कंप्लाइंग विद सच रिक्वायरमेंट एज मे बी प्रिस्क्राइब्ड. And where more than one certificate has been issued in connection with a policy, or when a copy of certificate has been issued, all those certificates or that copy, as the case may be, ठीक है? तो यहाँ पे ये यह है कि सर्टिफिकेट का मतलब हो गया पहला इंश्योरर वो हो गया जो रजिस्टर्ड है, किसमें वो एक्ट बताया गया उसके अकॉर्डिंग, ठीक है। दूसरा क्या कि सर्टिफिकेट कौन सा हो गया जो उस इंश्योरर ने सर्टिफिकेट इशू किया है, दिस इज द सेकंड थिंग। फिर है लाइबिलिटी, द वर्ड लाइबिलिटी इज हेयर यूज इन रिलेशन टू द डेथ ऑफ और बॉडीली इंजरी टू दैट पर्सन, इट इंक्लूड्स लाइबिलिटी इन रेस्पेक्ट देयर ऑफ अंडर सेक्शन 140। पॉलिसी ऑफ इंश्योरेंस, पॉलिसी ऑफ इंश्योरेंस इंक्लूड सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ इंश्योरेंस। प्रॉपर्टी, द वर्ड प्रॉपर्टी इंक्लूड्स गुड्स कैरिड इन द मोटर व्हीकल, रोड, ब्रिज, ठीक है, कल्वर्स, कॉजवेज, ट्रीज, पोस्ट, माइलस्टोन। ठीक है, अब प्रॉपर्टी क्या क्या हो गई, आपने देखा होगा सड़क पे कितने सारे चिन्ह लगाए जाते हैं, निशान लगाए जाते हैं, वो सब इसका सब्जेक्ट मैटर है, प्रॉपर्टी में सब आते हैं। तो गुड्स, गुड्स एज डिफाइंड इन सेक्शन 213 ऑफ द एक्ट इंक्लूड्स लाइव स्टॉक एंड एनीथिंग कैरिड बाय अ व्हीकल एक्सेप्ट लिविंग पर्सन एंड देयर लगेज, हमने ऑलरेडी डेफिनेशन देखी थी। रेसिप्रोकेटिंग कंट्री, दिस वर्ड मीन्स सच कंट्री एज मे बी द बेसिस ऑफ रेसिप्रोसिटी बी नोटिफाइड बाय द सेंट्रल, जो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ने ऑफिशियल गजट में जिसे रेसिप्रोसिटी माना है, रेसिप्रोकेटिंग कंट्री माना है, वो कंट्री इसमें आ जाएंगे, गवर्नमेंट का काम है ये। थर्ड पार्टी, द वर्ड थर्ड पार्टी इंक्लूड द गवर्नमेंट, ठीक है, यहाँ पे थर्ड पार्टी, द थर्ड पार्टी वर्ड इंक्लूड द गवर्नमेंट, सेक्शन 146 ऑफ द एक्ट प्रोवाइड फॉर द नेसेसिटी फॉर इंश्योरेंस अगेंस्ट थर्ड पार्टी रिस्क अकॉर्डिंग टू द सब सेक्शन 1, नो पर्सन शैल यूज एक्सेप्ट एज अ पैसेंजर और कॉज अलाउ एनी अदर पर्सन टू यूज अ मोटर व्हीकल इन अ पब्लिक प्लेस अंडर द सॉरी अनलेस देयर इज इन फोर्स इन रिलेशन टू द यूज ऑफ व्हीकल by the person of the other person as cause may be a policy of insurance comply with the requirement of this chapter। देखिए थर्ड पार्टी रिस्क में हमने जब बात की थी तो फर्स्ट है वो इंश्योरेंस कंपनी है, जो सेकंड पार्टी है जो insure, जिसे इंश्योर्ड किया गया है, थर्ड पार्टी कोई भी हो सकती है, थर्ड पार्टी गवर्नमेंट भी हो सकती है। तो यहाँ पे डेफिनेशन में याद रखिएगा, kindly remember, do remember कि थर्ड पार्टी, द वर्ड थर्ड पार्टी इंक्लूड द गवर्नमेंट, गवर्नमेंट उसमें आ सकती है लेकिन सिर्फ गवर्नमेंट ऐसा नहीं कहा है। ओके, काइंडली रिमेंबर दिस डेफिनेशन, आई हैव डिस्कस्ड द डेफिनेशन इन डिटेल आल्सो। अब फिर है कि व्हाई रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ व्हीकल इज मैंडेटरी, क्यों रजिस्ट्रेशन कवर करवाया जाता है। ओके, रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ अ व्हीकल व्हीकल इज अ नेसेसिटी अंडर सेक्शन 39 ऑफ मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट 1988 व्हिच क्लियरली स्टेट्स दैट अ पर्सन शुड ड्राइव अ मोटर व्हीकल और नॉट अलाउ एनीवन टू ड्राइव अ मोटर व्हीकल अंटिल द व्हीकल इज रजिस्टर्ड, ठीक है ना। क्योंकि रजिस्ट्रेशन इसलिए नेसेसरी है क्योंकि सेक्शन 39 में लिखा है कि अगर आपने अगर रजिस्ट्रेशन नहीं करवाया है तो क्या होगा, अगर रजिस्ट्रेशन नहीं करा तो यू कांट ड्राइव, दैट्स व्हाई रजिस्ट्रेशन इज मैंडेटरी। बाय रजिस्टरिंग द मोटर व्हीकल द प्रूफ ऑफ ओनरशिप ऑफ द व्हीकल इज नोन बाय द गवर्नमेंट विच एंश्योर्स इट्स सेफ्टी एंड इट हेल्प्स vehicle of the known the government which ensures its safety and it also helps for reselling of vehicle legally, it also helps in easy tracking of vehicle which is governed by transport ministry who keeps a record of all vehicles। okay, इन where to register a vehicle, register को कहां आपको vehicle को कहां register करना है। In India registration of the vehicle is done under RTO, ओके, रीजनल ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफिस, आरटीओ क्या है, रीजनल ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफिस एक्ट, एस्टेब्लिश एज अ गवर्नमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फॉर मॉनिटरिंग द व्हीकल और व्हीकल ऑन रोड एंड फॉर इशूइंग ड्राइवर लाइसेंस। द अदर वर्क ऑफ आरटीओ इज टू कलेक्ट टैक्स, चेक पॉल्यूशन एंड एनफोर्स ट्रांसपोर्टेशन रूल्स। ओके, तो देर आर सॉरी दीज आर लोकेटेड इन एवरी स्टेट एंड फंक्शंस अंडर मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट। तो आरटीओ कहाँ पे किस में काम करते हैं, जो आरटीओ है ना, जो रीजनल ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफिसेज है, दे आर वर्किंग अंडर द मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट। देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ रजिस्ट्रेशन, मेड परमानेंट रजिस्ट्रेशन एंड टेम्प्रेरी रजिस्ट्रेशन, वेयर वंस रजिस्ट्रेशन इज मेड परमानेंटली द रजिस्ट्रेशन नंबर कैन नॉट बी अल्टर्ड एंड इफ टेम्प्रेरी रजिस्ट्रेशन इज मेड देन इट कैन नॉट बी एक्सिड मोर देन अ मंथ एंड कैन नॉट बी रिन्यूड एज पर चैप्टर 14 सेक्शन 43 ऑफ मोटर व्हीकल एक्ट। What documents are required for the registration? आपको registration करवाना है तो कौन कौन से documents required होंगे? When we buy a vehicle, it is necessary to register a vehicle under the Motor Vehicle Act 1988. For registering the vehicle, one has to visit the nearest RTO office and in some cases, motor vehicle dealers register the vehicle on the behalf of the owner in exchange for the amount which is to be paid for registering the vehicle. As per Section 41 of the Motor Vehicle Act 1988, following are the procedure that the owner has to follow the registering the motor vehicle. Okay, form 20 भरना पड़ेगा. Form 20 is a motor vehicle registration application which has to be filled as per rule 47. Form 21, which is sale certificate issued by the manufacturer or dealer, आपको बेचा गया है वो आपको certificate दिखाना होगा. Form 34, which is detailing regarding loan hypothecation, अगर आपने loan लिया है वो चीज clear करनी होगी. Pollution under control certificate, ठीक है ना, PUC, pollution under control PUC certificate आपको दिखाना पड़ेगा, which is issued by the Ministry of Road Transport and Highway, Government of India. As per section 44, it is required to present the vehicle physically before registration. Evidence of payment of motor vehicle receipt issued by the dealer. As per section 43, temporary registration number, identity proof of residence, Aadhaar, passport, PAN, voter ID, car, driving license, whatever it is. In case of case, if there is a transfer of ownership, then form 29 is filled. Okay. So what are the consequences of non-registration of vehicle? So traffic laws operate when a vehicle is not registered and when the driver of a motor vehicle does not carry the certificate of motor vehicle registration, the violation has to pay fine. Then you have to pay fine. Okay. However, when a new car which is not registered under the Motor Vehicle Act 1988, then in case of dealer provides the owner with a temporary number which is valid for a month, and the owner has to apply for permanent registration number within the expiry of the given period. As per the Motor Vehicle Act, punishment for not adhering the laws in the definition from section 177 to 210D. Now, अब हम बात करें इंश्योरेंस में, हमने बात करी थर्ड पार्टी कौन हो सकता है, गवर्नमेंट हो सकता है, इट इंक्लूड्स गवर्नमेंट, बट ओनली गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट थर्ड पार्टी. थर्ड पार्टी कोई भी हो सकता है, इंडिविजुअल भी हो सकता है. ओके, देर आर टू क्वाइट डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ इंश्योरेंस इन्वॉल्व इन द डैमेजेस सिस्टम. वन इज अ थर्ड पार्टी लाइबिलिटी इंश्योरर, विच इज जस्ट कॉल्ड लाइबिलिटी इंश्योरेंस बाय इंश्योरेंस कंपनी, एंड द अदर वन इज फर्स्ट पार्टी इंश्योरेंस. अ थर्ड पार्टी इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसी इज अ पॉलिसी अंडर विच the insurance company agrees to indemnify the insured person if he is sued or held legally liable for injuries or damage done to a third party. The insured is one party, the insurance company is the second party, and the person you insured or injured who claim damages against you is the third party. Okay, and the third party includes government. National Insurance Company Limited versus Fakir Chand, third party should include everyone other than the contracting parties to the insurance policy, be it a person traveling in another vehicle, one walking on the road, or a passenger in the vehicle itself, which is the subject matter of insurance policy. Now, the salient features of third party insurance. Third party insurance is compulsory for all motor vehicle. Okay, in G. Govindan versus New Delhi Assurance Company Limited, third party risk insurance is mandatory under the statute. This provision cannot be overridden by any clause of the insurance policy. Third party insurance does not cover injuries to the insured himself. जिसने insurance लिया है उसकी किसी भी injury को cover नहीं करता है, but to the rest of the world who is injured by the insured. Beneficiary of third party insurance is the injured third party. The insured of the or the policy holder is only nominally the beneficiary of the policy. In practice, the money is always paid directed by the insurance company to the third party and does not even pass through the hands of the insured person. In third party policy, the premium do not vary with the values of what is being insured. Okay, because what is insured is legal liability, and it is not possible to know in advance what will be the liability, which kind of liability will be there in future. Future mein kaisi liability arise hogi, kya damage honge, abhi aisa hum nahi keh sakte. So the third party insurance is almost entirely fault based, means you have to prove that fault of the insured person and also that the injury occurred from the fault of the insured to claim damages from him. Third party insurance involves lawyers' aid. The third party insurance is unpopular with insurance companies as compared to the first party insurance, because they never know the maximum amount they will have to pay under third party policy. Okay, अब हम बात करते हैं amendments की, जो latest amendments आए हैं. तो कंपनसेशन फॉर रोड एक्सीडेंट विक्टिम, तो पहली चीज इसमें जो इंक्लूड की गई है द बिल नॉट द बिल नाउ एक्ट द इंक्रीज इन द मिनिमम कंपनसेशन फॉर द हिट एंड रन केस. तो पहले क्या था फॉलोज, इन केस ऑफ डेथ क्या है 25,000 to 2 lakh rupees हो गया है, इन केसेस ऑफ ग्रीवियस इंजरी 12,500 to 50,000 तक हो गया है. रिकॉल ऑफ व्हीकल, द न्यू बिल अलाउज द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट टू ऑर्डर द रिकॉल एंड डिफेक्टेड मोटर व्हीकल्स विच मे हार्म द एनवायरमेंट और द ड्राइवर और द रोड यूजर, रिकॉल द व्हीकल्स. ठीक है ना, ये सेकेंड इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोविजन है जो अमेंड हुआ है. रोड सेफ्टी बोर्ड, द नेशनल रोड सेफ्टी बोर्ड विल बी क्रिएटेड बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट टू एडवाइज द सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स ऑन ऑल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ रोड सेफ्टी एंड ट्रैफिक मैनेजमेंट. ओके, अब ऑफेंसेज एंड फाइन, देखो जनरल ऑफेंसेज एंड फाइन है बट अगेन देर इज अ लिस्ट. ओके, सो द बिल हैज न्यू इंक्रीजेस फाइन फॉर सेवरल ऑफेंसेज अंडर द एक्ट. फाइन फॉर ड्रिंकिंग एंड ड्राइविंग, नो नाउ द ऑफेंस सॉरी नाउ द फाइन इज इंक्रीज फ्रॉम 2,000 to 10,000 with imprisonment of 6 months, on the repetition it would be 15,000. Rash driving will cost ₹5,000, earlier it was 1,000. Driving without driving license will be fined 5,000 instead of 500 earlier. Offense by juvenile is new category introduced. Now guardian of the juvenile, owner of the vehicle, shall be fined 25,000 with 3 years imprisonment. ठीक है ना, shall be fined. Okay, for juvenile to be tried under juvenile justice act, registration of motor vehicle shall be cancelled. If a vehicle manufacturer fails to comply with motor vehicle standard, the penalty will be fine of up to 100 crore or imprisonment up to 1 year or both. If a contractor fails to comply with the road design standard, the penalty will be 1 lakh. Under Section 196 of Motor Vehicle Act 2019, driving without insurance will be fined ₹2,000. Under Section 194D of the Act, riding without helmet will be fined ₹1,000 and disqualification of 3 months for license. Under Section 194B of the Act, driving without seat belt with cost of ₹1,000, speeding or racing will be fined 5,000 instead of 500 earlier. Under Section 194E of the Act, not providing way for emergency vehicle will cost ₹10,000. Okay, new proposed fine ki jo ek list hai, another file attached, I will attach a file, okay, for that. So, student, thank you so much. Kindly try to complete the entire act with the bare provisions. Okay? So, thank you so much.